हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू दिस सेशन ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग ग्राफिक्स एंड डिज़ाइन। माई सेल्फ विमल सलोद फ्रॉम एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आइसोमेट्रिक प्रोजेक्शन। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज आइसोमेट्रिक प्रोजेक्शन एंड व्हाट इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ आइसोमेट्रिक प्रोजेक्शन। आइसोमेट्रिक प्रोजेक्शन इट इज़ वन टाइप ऑफ पिक्टोरियल प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट। Orthographic projection or two dimensional drawing is useful for the persons who are technically trained, but the persons who are not technically trained, for them to visualize the object isometric view is very useful. Now let us understand the principle of isometric projection with a simple example. Here one three dimensional object and it is cube. It is shown over here. It has top base and bottom base. Both of these base are square. Let us nominate this top base as A, B, C and D. There are two diagonals, AC and BD. These are the two diagonals. The intersecting point of these two diagonals is point O. The inclination angle of this AD is 30 degree as shown here. So when any object is placed in such a way that all the three dimensions can be visualized from any direction, then its actual dimension or the original size of the object is reduced by some extent. And isometric means equal measurement. So what happens in case of isometric projection, all the three axes of the dimension, that is length, width and height, all the three axes are reduced with equal measurement up to some extent. Now three axes are, let us consider as OX, OY and OZ. As OS is the length of axis of the length, it is axis for the height, and OZ axis for the width. And if we measure the inclination angle in this condition, then the inclination angle will be 120 degree for each case. Here this angle in between OX and OZ is 120. Here also it is 120, and here also it is 120 degree. So in case of isometric projection, all the three dimensions of the object are equally reduced, and the angle between the three axes are also equal, and that is 120 degree. That's why it is known as isometric equal measurement, isometric projection. Now as we discussed, in case of isometric projection, the original dimension is reduced. So as compared to two lengths, up to how much extent it is reduced, that relation we have to derive. So for that we are considering geometry of this figure. Here this triangle AOD is drawn separately over here. This angle, if you measure, it is 30 degree on both the sides. 30 degree angle. Now this geometry is separately drawn. So AO is this line, and from O point this is OD line. AOD is same triangle as shown here, but it is drawn with the larger scale to understand the principle in a better way. So AOD is the triangle and this inclination angle is 30 degrees. Here this AD length is isometric length, and this angle is reduced and it is 30 degree angle. So this angle is 30 degrees. But in case of square, we know that the true length is inclined at an angle of 45 degrees. So here 81 is the true length, and it should be inclined at an angle of 45 degree. Here AD is isometric length. AD is isometric length and angle is 30 degree. 81 is true length, and this true inclination angle is 45 degree. So from this basic concept, we are going to derive the relation between true length and isometric length. AD1 is true length, AD is isometric length. So considering this geometry, now take cosine of this 30 degree. Cos 30 degree is equal to OA by AD. AD is hypotenuse. OA by AD, that is equal to square root of 3 by 2. And if we consider cosine of 45 degree, then cos 45 degree is equal to OA by AD1, that is equal to 1 by square root of 2. Now take ratio of cos 45 by cos 30 degree, that is equal to AD by AD1, and substitute these numerical values. So we get the answer 0.816. But we know that AD is isometric length and AD1 is two length. So we can say isometric length is equal to 0.186 into two length. It is the basic principle of isometric projection. It is basic principle for isometric projection. It means that isometric length reduced by 0.816 times the true length. Now from question viewpoint, there are two types of the question are asked, isometric view and another is to draw isometric projection. So there are two types for isometric drawing. One is isometric view and another is isometric projection. In case of isometric view, the original dimension of the object are to be considered. Here same object is shown, but length, width and height, three dimensions are different. As you can see from this diagram, here original dimensions of the object are taken to prepare the isometric view, but in case of isometric projection, we have to consider the reduced dimension, that is isometric length, width and height. So considering that dimension, this object is drawn here. So it can be compared for the same object. If isometric projection is asked, then the dimension becomes somewhat smaller as compared to isometric view. Now let's see example. Construct a isometric scale of 50 mm length. To prepare isometric projection, it is necessary in first step to prepare the isometric scale. Here we have to prepare the isometric scale for 50 mm length. So true length is 50 mm, that is to be taken at an angle of 45 degrees. So first draw horizontal line, OA is horizontal line. From A point, draw a line at an inclination angle of 45 degrees. This AD1 is true length and it is equal to 50 mm. Now let us divide this 50 mm into 5 parts. So we can consider 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50 mm dimensions. So total length is 50 mm. From D1 point, draw vertical line. All the dimensions are true length. Now from A point, draw a line at an angle of 30 degree, because we know that isometric length is to be taken at 30 degree angle. So from 30 degree angle, draw this AD line. On AD line, we will get the isometric length. Now from each and every division numbers, from 10, 20, 30, 40, we have to draw vertical lines. As shown here, from 10, draw a vertical line. Here, this dimension is 10 days. From 20, 30, 40, from all these points, you have to draw the vertical line. So it is a scale prepared for 50 mm length. Now, for 50 mm true length, its isometric length is, you have to measure for that from A to D. So this much length, AD length, is isometric length for 50 mm. If you want isometric length of 30 mm, then consider this A point. From A point to 30 days, this much length is isometric length for 30 mm dimension. In this way, we can find out the required isometric length from the isometric scale. Next example is, front view of the object is given. Prepare its isometric view. So front view of the object is shown here, that is circle, and it is orthographic view. Orthographic view is two-dimensional view, and in two-dimensional view, in case of front view, we can see length and height. But as it is a circle, it has both the dimensions similar, length and height, both are equal to 40 mm. To prepare isometric view of a circle, that method is known as the four-center method also. So it is a four-center method to draw the isometric circle. So we are considering this direction as front view. So from this direction, we have to consider length and height. In first step, draw a rhombus of size 40 mm because diameter of circle is 40. So draw a rhombus of 40 mm size, which is length 40 mm and height 40 mm. So it is a rhombus of 40 by 40 mm size. Write down the notations for rhombus. A, B, C, D is the given rhombus. This angle is 30 degree angle. Now mark midpoint of both the sides of the rhombus. So these are the midpoints of both the sides. Also write down notations for the midpoint. Let's take it as P, Q, R and S. These are the midpoints. So now rhombus has two diagonals. One is shorter diagonal, that is BD diagonal, and another is longer diagonal, that is AC diagonal. Isometric, in case of four center method, we are going to use four centers to prepare isometric view. So here, the two points of this shorter diagonal are actually two center points. Join the diagonal BD and AC. Now consider this B point of shorter diagonal and join with B point. Then consider another point D of shorter diagonal and join it with R point. So there are two lines are prepared, BR and PB. And now C1 and C2 points are actually two points of the shorter diagonal. So we have two center points. Keep C1 as the center. Take compass size equal to C1P. This much distance as the compass size and draw an arc. Then take C2 as the center. Compass size equal to C2R and draw another arc. Now the intersecting point of this BR line and this PB line with longer diagonal AC is actually two center points, C3 and C4. So these are the two additional center points, C3 and C4. Keep C3 as the center, take compass size equal to C3S and draw an arc. Then keep C4 as the center, take compass size equal to C4P and draw an arc. You can also take compass size equal to C4Q. C4Q is equal to C4P. So any compass size can be taken and draw this arc. Thus this isometric view of circle is completed. It is also known as four center method. As we are using four centers to prepare isometric view. Now next example is, top view of the object is given, prepare its isometric view. So it is a top view of the object and you can say it is a circle, and in case of top view we can see two dimensions, that is length and width. So third dimension height is not visible, so that third dimension we don't have to consider while preparing isometric view. It is the same object circle. So we have to prepare isometric circle as we have seen the procedure. But here the third axis height is not considered. to prepare rhombus, it is length 40 and it is width 40. So by taking 40 by 40, this rhombus is prepared. And then by applying the same procedure, we can construct the isometric circle in top view. So it is a procedure how we can draw isometric circle, how we can prepare the isometric scale, what is the difference between isometric view and isometric projection, and what is the basic principle of isometric projection. Thank you very much.